past six. Now on BBC Two, it's Final Score.
Good afternoon. Throughout this football season, there's never been a dull moment, and today's results are of vital importance for clubs fighting for a title, for promotion, a playoff place, or to avoid relegation. Gary Pallister, Steve Claridge and Garth Crooks are watching the closing stages of today's Barclays Premier League matches and events at St James's Park have been holding their attention. Alan Shearer is in charge of third-bottom Newcastle for the first time since Wednesday, when Newcastle's all-time top scorer took on the challenge of trying to save the club's top-flight status. The atmosphere on Tyneside has been electric. How have the team responded? They're playing Chelsea. Andrew James reporting.
Ray, it's Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2. They came, they saw, and they'll probably go home disappointed. 52,000, another full house at Newcastle, their third of the season. They were doing well in the first half, plenty of endeavour, plenty of running. Chelsea looked below par. But then in the second half, Lampard got his 11th goal of the Premiership season, and that was quickly followed by a second Chelsea goal from Malouda, whereas Newcastle have barely put a shot in on the Petacek goal to trouble Chelsea. It's disappointing here, Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2.
There's a vital equaliser for Nottingham Forest, third bottom in the Championship, through Rob Earnshaw away at Barnsley. Barnsley 1, Nottingham Forest 1. Back to the Barclays Premier League. Arsenal have aspirations of an FA Cup and Champions League double, but it's Premier League points at stake this afternoon via a home game with Manchester City. David Garrido's of the Emirates.
It's Arsenal 2, Manchester City 0, Ren. How the Gunners have missed Cesc Fabregas, not only their club captain as Walcott. Fires one, it's just saved by Shay Given. But Fabregas also the man to knit the play together and provide that creativity. His free kick floated into the box right onto the head of Manuel Adebayor to give Arsenal the lead. And after the break, another perfect Fabregas delivery, this time from open play, expertly controlled by Adebayor, rounding the keeper and siphoning home to take his tally to 14 for this season. City have had their chances too. Gelson Fernandez striking a post. Mika Richards having a shot saved well by the legs of Manuel Albunia. But Mark Hughes' demeanour says it all. Arms folded and furrowed brow. Arsenal 2, City 0.
First of seven games in 23 days for Arsenal. West Bromwich Albion just can't afford to lose at home today. They're playing relegation rival Stoke. Ivan Gaskell reporting.
Yes, they're surely going to. West Brom 0, Stoke City 2. 18 minutes left. West Brom's Premier League life slowly draining away. Architects of their own downfall yet again. Awful defensive lapses allowed in Ricardo Fuller early in the first half and again early in the second half. This time BT capitalised. West Brom have thrown on three second-half subs. Brunt's hit the bar, but it's looking grim for Tony Mowbray's men. 2-0 Stoke.
What a day to get your first away win of the season. To the Reebok, Bolton were 5 points above the relegation places when the match with Middlesbrough kicked off. Second bottom Borough in big trouble, having won one of the last 18 games. Richard Ascombe reporting.
Bolton 2, Middlesbrough 1. Ray, Middlesbrough battling away against a Bolton side who punished them rather poor defending as Matt Taylor just close for Bolton. Kevin Davies sneaked in to give Wanderers the lead, and after Gary O'Neill equalised for the visitors, their back four switched off again, and Gary Cahill poked home a second just before the break. The second period, though, has seen Borough show real steel. Tunchai has gone close with three volleys, but at the moment it's Bolton who have the lead.
Every point is precious for Hull and Portsmouth, both trying to keep away from the relegation places. Let's hear the latest news from Steve Sutton.
Well, at the moment, Ray, they're heading for a point each because it's 0-0. The best chance of this second half fell to Hull City. Kabul attempted a backheader to David James. He left it short. Craig Fagan nipped in. He sent his header goalbound. It looked as if it would break the deadlock, but an acrobatic backwards dive from David James clawed the ball away. It's 0-0.
Southampton 1, Charlton 3. Charlton bottom of the Championship, Southampton second bottom. Whatever the result, doesn't look like Charlton will be able to get safe, but Southampton have a chance, and don't forget they're fighting relegation and liquidation. Nick Bailey with Charlton's third goal on 69 minutes. To Upton Park, where West Ham are playing Sunderland. Sunderland arrived 3 points above a relegation place in the Barclays Premier League. Tony Lockwood reporting.
It's West Ham 2, Sunderland 0. Sunderland without a win in their last five Premier League games. It looks like being six. James Tomkins with a header that's given the Hammers some breathing space and that two-goal cushion. Junior Stanislas on his West Ham debut claimed his first senior goal late in the first half. Sunderland with it all to do and a worrying injury for Jonathan Spector. An aerial clash with Tal Ben-Haim stretching off, requiring oxygen. Collins is on for Spector, and West Ham leads Sunderland by 2-0.
Still time for goals to be scored and the situation to change in those matches. Here's the details on the Barclays Premier League match already over. Blackburn versus Tottenham. Damian Johnson watched the game at Ewood Park.
Blackburn Rovers 2.
That result and the latest scores in today's matches. Here's the Barclays Premier League table as things stand. And in the bottom half, West Bromwich Albion 24 points, Middlesbrough 27, Newcastle 29. The three North East clubs together. Looks like only one of them will stay up at the moment. Then Portsmouth on 33 points, Hull City on 34. Blackburn, a vital win for them today, Garth. That zooms them up the table. 5 points from the relegation places now. Stoke and Bolton, imagine they're going to be safe.
Well, I think Portsmouth, Sunderland, probably Newcastle now have really got something to do because the Blackburn result has actually upped the ante, and that's very important.
Steve, what's your reading of the relegation issue now?
Well, I mean, there's a psychological factor as well involved in being in the bottom three. You know, nobody down there is picking up points, and that's the difficulty.
Gary Pallister, would you agree West Bromwich Albion and Middlesbrough, both down, not going to get out of trouble?
I'm not going to give up on my old club, Middlesbrough, yeah, West Brom, yeah. I mean, another horrendous defeat against Stoke, the only team in England who hadn't won away from home this season. Shocking defending, haven't been able to defend all season, and, yeah, the trapdoor's open for them.
And let's look at the top half of the table. As things stand, the goals scored can change the situation around. Chelsea go in second. Manchester United play tomorrow, of course. Liverpool play this evening away at Fulham. If they avoid defeat, they go top of the table. But Arsenal got players fit at the right time. Looks like they're securing fourth spot. Aston Villa fifth, Everton sixth. West Ham in seventh in the moment. That will bring a Europa League place. And you do wonder sometimes, though, how many clubs actually want to qualify for the Europa League place. Situation as far as the Grand National is concerned, 100-1 shot. Monmouth has won the biggest prize winner since 1967. 100-1 shot. Monmouth has won the Grand National. To Scotland, Dundee United 2, Hibs 2. The final score in the SPL game played this lunchtime. It's tight in the title race. Celtic had a 3-point lead over second-place Rangers when a home game with Hamilton kicked off. Ian Turner's at Celtic Park.
It's Celtic 3, Hamilton 0, and it's one of those games now where both sides are relatively content. Injury hit Hamilton are working hard and keeping it respectable, and Celtic are happy that the points appear to be secure. Gordon Strachan sided the job done by midway through the first half, by which time Samaras and McGeady had scored. Samaras has since added a third, and Celtic are going 6 points clear.
Yeah, Celtic 6 points clear. Rangers play tomorrow away at bottom of the table, Falkirk. Back to the Reebok. Bolton against Middlesbrough. Richard Ascombe.
This game is all over, Ray, and when your luck is out, your luck is out. Matt Taylor with a free kick on the far side, way from goal, yards from goal, maybe 60 yards from goal. He hit it. The Borough defence failed to deal with it. So did Brad Jones in the Middlesbrough goal as well, and it rather bounced aimlessly and almost harmlessly into the back of the net. But that's the end of this game. Bolton 3, Middlesbrough 1.
Hartlepool not safe from relegation in League 1. Hereford all but down, and 3 points for Hartlepool. They only kicked off 1 point above the relegation places, would be very important for them. Vinnie Printer confirming Bolton beating Middlesbrough. One win in 19, the situation is going to be for Middlesbrough now. They spent the last decade in the Barclays Premier League, averaging 11th. Looks like it's going down to the Championship. Let's go back to Celtic Park. Celtic at home to Hamilton, Ian Turner.
Well, the Celtic players are round Jan Venegor of Hesselink because it's been a hard season for him, but he has just scored Celtic's fourth from very close range. A tap-in after great work down the right. It's only his third goal of the season. Celtic celebrating. The points are safe. Celtic 4, Hamilton 0.
And the goal difference improving as well. Turning to the Coca-Cola Championship. Top two play on Monday. Wolves play away at Birmingham. In today's games, third place Reading can't afford to lose at Coventry. They arrived 4 points from an automatic promotion place. Steve Lee can tell us how they're faring. No Steve Lee at the moment. Coventry City 0, Reading 0. Later score at the Ricoh Arena. Bristol City versus Preston, the two clubs just outside the playoffs. That kicks off at 20 past five. Cardiff Swansea tomorrow. The teams are 6th and 8th at 3 o'clock. A win for Sheffield United today would put them within 3 points of automatic promotion. Harry Grayson's at Bramall Lane.
Well, Sheffield United are brushing aside most teams at the moment, Ray, playing with such confidence. Greg Halford and Darius Henderson scored in the first half. And in the second, Montgomery, Henderson again and Jamie Ward all should have added to the stroll in the park. Ipswich fans quiet. They're lacklustre up front, to say the least.
The nightmare for Derby County fans would be to lose form at the wrong time and slide towards a successive relegation. Opponents Burnley in with a chance of promotion. Ben Jacobs reporting.
Derby nil, Burnley one. Chris McCann got the goal, but Derby keeper Stephen Bywater won't be happy with it. Chris Eagles whipped in a low cross under pressure from McCann. Bywater then shirked away the ball, hit him on his backside and ricocheted to McCann, who tapped in. So as things stand, Derby aren't quite safe. Burnley, though, could be dark horses for automatic promotion. 10 minutes to play. It's Derby nil, Burnley one.
Yeah, Burnley and Sheffield United in the automatic promotion race. Last time Burnley were in the top flight, 1976. Southampton and Charlton were second bottom and bottom at 3 o'clock. Charlton just about certain to go down, whatever today's result. And Southampton fighting against relegation and liquidation. Mark Bishop's at St Mary's.
Southampton 1, Charlton 3, like two heavyweight boxers slugging it out for survival. It's Charlton that look as if they could be sending Southampton ever closer to the third tier for the first time in nearly 50 years. Shelby Raccon and another goal from Nicky Bailey has done the damage. 28,000 Saints fans inside St Mary's. They thought they were back in the game when McGoldrick equalised. But it's all Charlton. They lead by 3-1.
Barnsley and Nottingham Forest, two of nine clubs with relegation worries. Forest in most trouble, third bottom going into today's matches, although a Forest win would really scare the clubs above them. Alan Biggs at Oakwell.
It's Barnsley 1, Nottingham Forest 1. You don't expect a classic in these circumstances, but certainly high drama at least in this second half. Jamal Campbell-Rice putting Barnsley in front with a 12-yard looping header and then having a tame penalty saved by Ian Turner. What a defining moment that could be, because Rob Earnshaw, who'd rattled the crossbar earlier in the half, fired in a terrific first-time shot from a low cross. Forest dare not lose this, but ideally they need to win. This far, a draw would be fair.
Norwich kicked off at home to mid-table Sheffield Wednesday, only 2 points above a relegation place. Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes is at Carrow Road.
And they've just scored! They finally got the equaliser they were looking for. It's 1-1 here at Carrow Road. I'm just trying to give you the score. Yes, it's David Mooney. It's that man. He's on loan from Reading, number 18. It's his third goal in 4 games for Norwich. But play's gone back on again. We've just had a bit of handbags, actually, as well. We've had 2 yellow cards after a bit of a row going on in the penalty area. So it's all going on here at Carrow Road. It's Norwich 1, Sheffield Wednesday 1.
It could be a priceless equaliser for Norwich. Coventry Reading, Steve Lee.
Yes, it's Coventry nil, Reading nil. We've played 82 minutes and really it has been a very poor game indeed, where the number of bookings, 7, has exceeded the number of half chances to either side. It's improved slightly in the last couple of minutes. Freddie Eastwood volleying over and then Guillaume Bezelin had a shot wide after a great layoff from Morrison. Jay Tabb, who used to play for Coventry, now playing for Reading, had one shot just wide, but no one can break the deadlock. We've got 9 minutes left. It's nil nil.
Let's go back to Carrow Road. Norwich thought they had an equaliser at home to Sheffield Wednesday. It would have been priceless too. Lizzie Greenwood-Hughes has been there, but the hopes have been dashed, Lizzie.
It's desperate here for the Norwich City fans. David Mooney was celebrating. The referee had given the goal. Everyone thought they'd finally got that equaliser. Remember, they're just 2 points off the drop zone here. They're desperate for a win to secure championship safety, but it was disallowed. The linesman waved and finally everyone noticed, and I'm afraid it's Norwich City nil, Sheffield Wednesday one.
Still time for Norwich to get an equaliser. Stranraer, Scottish Division 2, will be relegated today because they're 3 down at home to Raith. Stranraer will be relegated from Scottish Division 2. Back to the Reebok, Bolton against Middlesbrough, Richard Ascombe.
It's certainly all over now, Ray. Bolton Wanderers 4-1. A long ball found Ricardo Gardner just inside the box. He controlled it with his right foot, slotted it home with his left. Bolton 4-1.
Not just a defeat, a demoralising defeat for Middlesbrough, who looked like they're going to be taking relegation on the chin. West Bromwich Albion losing at home to Stoke today. Looks like two of the relegation places in the Barclays Premier League are just about settled. Anything can happen, of course, between now and the end of the season, but both those teams in desperate trouble. Newcastle, third bottom, at home to Chelsea. Will the sheer effect do any good for them by the end of the season? Not today, as far as the result is concerned. Andrew James.
Right, certainly looks that way, doesn't it? Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2. The big incident since you were last here. An effort from Michael Owen, brought back into the starting lineup as captain today by Shearer. He thought he'd got the ball over the line, and by his arm movement suggesting about a metre over the line, the linesman wasn't having any of it as Ashley Cole kicked it off the line. And all the frustration of Newcastle hasn't really translated into an improved and gutsy finish to this game. They trail by 2-0, and Chelsea's title train is back on the tracks.
Yeah, Stranraer relegated Scottish Division 2. Top two in Scottish Division 1 playing this afternoon. St Johnstone and Partick, it's 1-1. Arsenal are reinforcing their position in fourth place in the Barclays Premier League table. David Garrido with the details.
Yes, yeah, still Arsenal 2, Man City 0. The Gunners still looking for a third goal. In fact, no chance now for a hat-trick for Emmanuel Adebayor. He's been subbed. Nick Bentner is on. He's just wasted a chance moments ago. Theo Walcott replaced by Emmanuel Abui, who blazed over as well. Cesc Fabregas, though, the real inspiration in this game, going off to a standing ovation. Arsenal 2, City 0.
West Bromwich Albion against Stoke. What a day to get your first top-flight away win since 1984, Ivan Gaskell.
Yes, West Brom 0, Stoke City 2. A limp surrender from West Brom, whose fans have been trailing out for about 10 minutes in their hundreds. Stoke's fans are still here. 2-0.
Doncaster 1, Watford 2. Doncaster pulling a goal back. They've lost the last three. Just about safe, but they could do with another couple of wins to make sure they stay in the championship. James Hayter with 5 minutes to go. Doncaster 1, Watford 2. Hull against Portsmouth. Steve Sutton, a goal for either team would be priceless.
Yes, it would, Ray. Well inside the last 5 minutes now, and it's 0-0, but Portsmouth down to 10 men. Glenn Johnson with a second yellow card for a late tackle on Marnie. Referee Chris Foy losing his patience. Red for Glenn Johnson. 0-0.
Notts County 1, Chester 2. Chester, second bottom in the Football League, trying to avoid being relegated. Let's go to Upton Park, West Ham against Sunderland, and hear from Tony Lockwood.
Where Sunderland are running out of time and running out of ideas. A long hold-up for an injury to Jonathan Spector. Goals from Stanislas and Tompkins. West Ham look comfortable. Sunderland with more problems. West Ham 2, Sunderland 0.
Sunderland fourth bottom as things stand. Into League One, the situation for automatic promotion is very tense. Leicester top, Peterborough second. They're away at Oldham today, watched by Natalie Jackson.
Yes, bad news for Leicester fans. Peterborough are 2-1 up here as Holden. With the minutes ebbing away, Peterborough scored. Mikhail Smith, the goal scorer, he tucked away the ball after a long ball picked him out. His second of the match. You have to feel sorry for Oldham, who've played really well here this afternoon. Oldham 1, Peterborough 2.
Let's hear about the League One leaders. Leicester there playing Carlisle. Losing to Peterborough last week cut the gap between the two teams to 4 points. Another setback today, perhaps. Maya Banji reporting.
Yeah, and the frustration here is all becoming apparent. Leicester 1, Carlisle 1. Goal from Bridges and Oakleave, the equaliser for Leicester. Frustration everywhere, as I say. Nigel Pearson has literally been in star jumps for the last 20 minutes down on the touchline. Carlisle will be very happy if it stays like this. Their point away to league leaders would be a great result for them. Leicester 1, Carlisle 1.
Final whistles in Scotland. Celtic of Hammond Hamilton 4-0, a 6 points clear at the top of the SPL. Back to the Coca-Cola Championship. Blackpool and Plymouth both in trouble, both fighting to move away from the relegation places. Naz Premji reporting.
Blackpool 0, Plymouth Argyle 1. It could be a priceless, priceless goal for the Pilgrims. And it's been scored by Gary Sawyer. Paul Gallagher with a corner from the right. Sawyer with a glancing header past Rahubka. It could be a vital win for the Pilgrims. It's Blackpool 0, Plymouth Argyle 1.
Yeah, those 3 points could be absolutely vital. Could be academic, whichever way the result goes. But there's another goal in the Southampton-Charlton match from Mark Bishop.
Ray, the nails are being bitten down here. Southampton 2, Charlton 3. A goal from Bradley Wright-Phillips has come off the substitutes bench. There's furore at the moment because the Southampton forwards think that they should have had a penalty. The referee has just gone over to the assistant referee, but it has been ruled out, no penalty given. So we await to see what happens now. It's Southampton 2, Charlton 3.
Let's go to Celtic Park for confirmation that Celtic are 6 points clear at the top of the SPL. Ian Turner.
They are indeed. Celtic 4, Hamilton 0. A 20th league win of the season for Gordon Strachan's side, and they do move 6 clear. Giorgio Samaras took his tally for the season to 16 with a goal in either half. Aidan McGeady helped himself to 1, and the stadium erupted when Jan Venegoor of Hesselink ended his goal drought with the 4th 8 minutes from time. And we end up with the same scoreline as the last time these two met here. Celtic 4, Hamilton 0.
Hearts against Kilmarnock in the SPL, Brian McLaughlin.
Yes, it's finished Hearts 3, Kilmarnock 1, and the Tynecastle side ever closer to securing third place than that vital European spot. But the story of the week has undoubtedly been the lifetime bans handed out by the SFA to Barry Ferguson and Alan McGregor and their subsequent suspension from the club's Rangers. There will now be an SFA inquiry into what has been called Boozegate. The big question, though, is who authorised the late-night drinking session on the return from Holland last week. This issue will not go away, and there's now a feeling that the future of manager George Burley may also be called into doubt.
George Burley's future being debated in Scotland. What do you think about an international lifetime ban for making V signs of the television cameras and a very incorrect late night drinking session?
Well, from what I can gather, the response in Scotland has been absolutely unanimous. They think it's outrageous, and the players have behaved in such an arrogant and fashion that it's hardly unsurprising they've been banned from international football.
Lifetime ban, Steve, would you agree with the severity of the punishment?
Well, on the face of it, it seems harsh, doesn't it? But, you know, these are not two of the integral players in that side, and they are expendable, and that's what happens when, you know, you're probably not the manager's first choice.
Right, let's go back to St James's Park. Newcastle against Chelsea, closing stages. Andrew James.
Well, it could so easily have been 3-0 to Chelsea Rangers just a few moments ago. Kalou in on goal, but well saved by Harper. It's very quiet and very disappointing for the home fans. Chelsea, though, singing. It's Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2.
Alan Shearer in charge of Newcastle for the first time today. The stadium was absolutely rocking. 7 more games after today to try and keep his team in the top flight of English football. Arsenal against Manchester City, David Garrido.
Arsenal 2, Man City 0. It's pretty much settled this one. Plenty of long-range efforts from both sides. Twice Theo Walcott having space to rifle in a shot, twice he's straight off target. He's been taken off, as has Cesc Fabregas. As I mentioned, he's gone off to a standing ovation, while Robinho, ineffective today, taken off to chants of "Who are you?" from the Emirates crowd. Harsh but true. Arsenal 2, Man City 0.
Can't be long to go at the Hawthorns. Can't be that long to go for West Bromwich Albion in the Barclays Premier League. But Stoke look like they're going to play their way to safety. Ivan Gaskell reporting.
And they're throwing bodies on the line to keep it that way. 50 seconds left. West Brom 0, Stoke City 2. Hardly any fans left.
Bolton against Middlesbrough now. Looks like Middlesbrough are going to have to do a lot of hard work. Will they be able to stay in the Barclays Premier League? One win in 19, Richard Ascombe.
Certainly doesn't look like it, Ray, as Tunçay just volleys over the bar. That's the fourth time he's done that today. Bolton are coasting, as you'd expect. Middlesbrough have never stopped fighting, but they've shown a real soft side to their underbelly in defence today. Ricardo Garner deserved his goal, mind you, Ray. He's been outstanding for the home side, who lead by 4-1.
Any chance of a late winner in the whole Portsmouth game? Steve Sutton will tell us.
Well, it doesn't look like it, Ray. It's still 0-0. Portsmouth down to 10 men. Hull can't win at home. Portsmouth can't win away, hence 0-0.
And Sunderland are in trouble. All the teams in the North East are in trouble. Sunderland losing at West Ham. Tony Lockwood reporting.
We'll have a considerable period of stoppage time because of that worrying injury for Jonathan Spector, who was stretched off. For Sunderland, one chance for Gibril Cissé through on goal, and he shot wide. It rather sums up their afternoon. West Ham 2, Sunderland 0.
A final whistle has gone at St James's Park. Newcastle playing Chelsea. The points go to Chelsea, and Alan Shearer and the Newcastle squad and the Newcastle fans have work to do to stay in the top flight of English football. Chelsea, on the other hand, just trying to be in a good position if Manchester United slip up again. Let's hear from Andrew James.
Newcastle 0, Chelsea 2, Ray. A full house to greet Shearer's return, but the drama of his pre-match welcome matched only by the comedy of Newcastle's defending and the injustice, perhaps, of a disallowed goal. Michael Owen, recalled by Shearer, thought his effort at 2-0 down had crossed the line by a yard before Ashley Cole hacked it away with the approval of Rob Stiles. But Shearer's biggest concern will be the gift of an opener to Chelsea, as first Duff and then Coloccini combined to malfunction as Lampard dispatched the clinic header. Minutes later, Malouda drove in a Route 1 second goal, and as Newcastle's heads dropped, 8 became 7 as the games begin to run out for Shearer to weave his magic. For Chelsea, it's business as usual in their pursuit of the title.
sombre Newcastle owner, Mike Ashley. Garth, any encouraging signs for Newcastle today?
Absolutely right. Definitely encouraging signs. It seems that Shearer has got his players focused on the four games that are winnable. This was a game that they were looking to pinch something, steal something from. It wasn't to be. But the other fixtures are winnable. They are bankable. And there's a basis now to go forward from this particular performance. So let's put things in perspective. This wasn't a game that Shearer would have put 3 points against his team.
What do you think Alan Shearer will be saying in the dressing room, having viewed that Newcastle performance today, Gary?
I think, you know, you go in there and you look for positives. He doesn't want to go in there and hammer his players. It's his first game in charge. I think he got a reaction from the team. I think he got a reaction from the crowd. I think he'd be delighted with the work rate and effort that they put in there. He was lacking a bit of quality. Michael Owen's still not probably match fit. He wanted to get in match fit. Maybe he could do with a run out in the reserves. I don't know. But on the whole, you know, as Gar said, he wouldn't have looked at that as a game he could get 3 points from. If he'd have got a draw, he'd have been delighted with it today. He got a response, and that's what he's going to take from it.
Let's hear about a late goal in the match between Leicester and Carlisle. Leicester, the League One leaders. Carlisle not safe from relegation. Mayo Banji reporting.
Yeah, and Leicester probably use their get-out-of-jail-free card this afternoon. Matt Fryett's header, 88 minutes in. A fantastic ball from Mattock, and Fryett was there on the penalty spot to head into the net. Leicester 2, Carlisle 1.
2 wins away from promotion. Derby against Burnley in the Championship. Ben Jacobs.
Derby 1, Burnley 1. The Derby captain, Paul Connolly, has just equalised with a diving header to possibly end Burnley's hopes of automatic promotion. Chris McCann got Burnley's goal. A simple tap-in from Chris Eaglescross. The full-time whistle has just gone. A point isn't a bad result for either side. It's Derby 1, Burnley 1.
Nottingham Forest have drawn away at Barnsley. Both teams with relegation fears. Forest need to start picking up points. Barnsley edging towards the safety line. Southend have won away at Huddersfield. Southend still within the chance of going to the playoffs. They did that last year. Final whistle at the Emirates. Arsenal 2, Manchester City 0. Torquay 2, Kettering 0 in the Blue Square Premier League. Coventry 0, Reading 0 in the Championship. That means that Reading aren't going to make any ground on the two automatic promotion places. Coventry 0, Reading 0, Reading in third place. Well, West Bromwich Albion against Stoke. Final whistle's gone at the Hawthorns. Ivan Gaskell.
Yes, West Brom 0, Stoke City 2. A 100-1 winner in the National. So what price West Brom repeating their great escape of 5 years ago? Well, on this evidence, rather longer odds. This a somewhat limp surrender. Once again, goal served on a plate with all the trimmings for their opponents. Early in the first half, again early in the second half, Fuller and Beattie said thank you very much. Stoke looking increasingly safe. Their first away top flight win in 37 attempts since 1984. West Brom surely down nil, Stoke City surely safe too.
All those people that said Stoke were definitely going down will have to think again. Hull against Portsmouth, Steve Sutton.
It's finished 0-0, Ray, but in the third minute of three added on, Portsmouth very nearly nicked it. The width of a post kept it out. Haridason headed goalwards. Duke in the Portsmouth goal let it go. I think he thought it was going out. It hit the post and then rolled out to safety. Right at the death, but it's ended 0-0.
Only 3 points out of 18 for Carlisle. They've got a late equaliser away at Leicester. Could be so important to them. West Ham against Sunderland. Sunderland in trouble. Tony Lockwood.
West Ham 2, Sunderland 0. The Hammers have European football on their minds. Sunderland's relegation worries got a whole lot worse. Junior Stanislas on his Hammers debut, marking a special occasion with his first goal. A simple side-foot finish late in the first half. And then after the restart, James Tompkins got goal side of a West Ham old boy in Anton Ferdinand. The header too good for Craig Gordon in the Sunderland goal. And West Ham deservedly win by 2-0.
Sunderland fourth bottom in the table, Newcastle third bottom, second bottom and stirring at relegation. Middlesbrough, one win in 19. Bolton nearly safe. Richard Ascombe.
They are right. Bolton 4, Middlesbrough 1. Once again, Borough rather fell on their sword. They never gave up but gave away 4 goals. Kevin Davis and Gary Cahill grabbed 2 either side of a smart finish from Gary O'Neill. Borough did have chances, Tunshai in particular, but once again undid all their good work. Matt Taylor's long free kick, drifting past defensive keeper and into the net before Ricardo Gardner put the seal on a comfortable victory to leave Borough in a very uncomfortable position in the Premier League table.
Let's go to the Emirates. Arsenal against Manchester City. And a comfortable victory for the Gunners, David Garrido will tell us.
In
Coventry against Reading in the Championship. Reading kicked off in third place. Steve Lee.
Coventry nil, Reading nil. Steve Coppell and the travelling Reading fans not best pleased. They've dropped points here in a match that was theirs for the taking. Hard to say who was worse, Coventry, Reading or the ref. Reading not making ground in the promotion race. On this evidence, they don't deserve to. Nil-nil.
Leicester have dropped points. The League One leaders eventually drawing 2-2 with Carlisle. 8 points off automatic promotion. Carlisle not safe from relegation. That is a very important point for them away from home. Sheffield United against Ipswich. Sheffield United, the Blades in the automatic promotion race in the Championship. Harry Gresham with all the details.
United had this game wrapped up, Ray, 30 minutes into the game. By then, they led 2-0. Greg Halford's 18-yard shot was a beauty, and Darius Henderson's header just underlined why the Blades are the form team at the moment in the Championship. They've got a bit of a roll on, to say the least.
Southampton, as we've been saying all afternoon, fighting relegation and possible liquidation. Charlton, bottom of the table. Southampton, second bottom. And Mark Bishop at St Mary's.
Southampton 2, Charlton Athletic 3. Saints move ever closer to the third tier for the first time in 50 years, Ray, after a game of high drama. Right at the end, both managers sent to the stands in injury time after a heated exchange on the touchline. Charlton too clever in the end. Shelby, Raccon and Bailey's goals were vital. Bradley Wright Phillips got one back off the subs bench, but Charlton held. Hold on. Southampton 2, Charlton Athletic 3.
And Southampton find out next week if they get a points deduction. Confirmation of all today's results is on the way now. And as this football season continues to build to a climax, every Saturday, final score will kick off via the red button at 2:30. BBC One or BBC Two viewers will join the programme at 4:30. Time now for Tim Gudgeon to confirm all today's final scores.
And kick off with the Barclays Premier League. Arsenal 2, Manchester City 0. Blackburn Rovers 2, Tottenham Hotspur 1. Bolton Wanderers 4, Middlesbrough 1. Fulham and Liverpool kick off in just about half an hour. Hull City 0, Portsmouth 0. Newcastle United 0, Chelsea 2. West Bromwich Albion 0, Stoke City 2. West Ham United 2, Sunderland 0. In the Coca-Cola Championship, Barnsley 1, Nottingham Forest 1. Blackpool 0, Plymouth Argyle 1. Bristol City and Preston North End kick off at 20 past 5. Coventry City 0, Reading 0. Derby County 1, Burnley 1. Doncaster Rovers 1, Watford 2. Norwich City 0, Sheffield Wednesday 1. Queen's Park Rangers 0, Crystal Palace 0. Sheffield United 2, Ipswich Town 0. Southampton 2, Charlton Athletic 3. And in Coca-Cola League 1, Cheltenham Town 0, Leighton Orient 1. Colchester United 0, Leeds United 1. Hartlepool United 4, Hereford United 2. Huddersfield Town 0, Southend United 1. Leicester City 2, Carlisle United 2. Millwall 3, Walsall 1. Milton Keynes Dons 2, Brighton and Hove Albion 0. Oldham Athletic 1, Peterborough United 2. Stockport County 0, Yeovil Town 0. Swindon Town 0, Crewe Alexandra 0. In League 2, Accrington Stanley 0, Lincoln City 2. Aldershot Town 0, Rotherham United 1. Bournemouth 4, Rochdale 0. Bradford City 1, Brentford 1. Darlington 0, Morecambe 0. Exeter City 2, Dagenham and Redbridge 1. Gillingham 0, Barnet 2. Macclesfield Town 1, Chesterfield 1. Notts County 1, Chester City 2. Port Vale 1, Bury 1. Shrewsbury Town 1, Grimsby Town 1. In the Blue Square Premier, Barrow 0, Woking 1. Cambridge United 0, Forest Green Rovers 1. Crawley Town 4, Burton Albion 0. Eastbourne Borough 3, Weymouth 0. Ebbsfleet United 1, Northwich Victoria 0. Grays Athletic 1, York City 0. Kidderminster Harriers 4, Stevenage Borough 2. Lewes 2, Altrincham 0. Oxford United 2, Histon 1. Rushton and Diamonds 2, Salisbury City 1. Torquay United 2, Kettering Town 0. Wrexham 2, Mansfield Town 0. The Clydesdale Bank Scottish Premier League, Celtic 4, Hamilton Academical, 0. Dundee United, 2. Hibernian, 2. Hearts, 3. Kilmarnock, 1. Inverness Caledonian Thistle, 2. St Mirren, 1. Motherwell, 1. Aberdeen, 1. The Arnbrew Scottish Division 1, Airdrie United 1, Dunfermline Athletic 1, Clyde 0, Livingston 1, Greenock Morton 2, Dundee 0, Queen of the South 1, Ross County 2, St Johnston 1, Partick Thistle 1, Scottish Div 2, Alloa Athletic 1, Peterhead 2, Ayr United 3, Stirling Albion 1, Brechin City 2, Queen's Park 0, East Fife, 0, Arbroath, 0. Stranraer, 0, Raith Rovers, 3. Scottish Div 3, Annan Athletic, 2, Montrose, 1. Berwick Rangers, 1, Albion Rovers, 1. Cowdenbeath, 1, Elgin City, 1. Forfar Athletic, 0, East Stirlingshire, 2. Stenhouse Muir, 0, Dumbarton, 2. In the Welsh Premier, Aberystwyth Town, 2, Newtown, 0. Carmarthen Town 1, Newy Cefn Druids 0, Fort Marrock 1, Port Talbot Town 2, Hrill 1, Airbus UK Broughton 0.
And Gary Pallister, Steve Claridge and Garth Crooks have watched all this afternoon's Barclays Premier League games. Hear their opinions on the top performances after we've looked at the updated league tables. First of all, here is the Barclays Premier League table with Liverpool involved in today's late kick-off at Fulham and Manchester United playing tomorrow. Chelsea have taken advantage to move up to second place on goal difference after their win at Newcastle. If Liverpool avoid defeat at Fulham, they go top of the table. In the battle for fourth place, Arsenal are now 6 points clear of Aston Villa, who visit Manchester United tomorrow. It's been a bad afternoon for the bottom three, who all lost. West Bromwich Albion, 8 points from safety with just 7 games to go. Middlesbrough and Newcastle also in grave danger. And the other North East club, Sunderland, slipping down to 17th after losing to West Ham. Stoke and Blackburn both won to move away from the relegation zone. The Coca-Cola Championship, leaders Wolves visit second place Birmingham on Monday night. Third place Reading couldn't take full advantage, drawing 0-0 at Coventry. On form, Sheffield United are now level with the Royals after beating Ipswich 2-0. Charlton's win at Southampton might give the Addicts a slim chance of survival. Certainly a huge blow to Saints' survival prospects. Nottingham Forest fought back to earn a crucial point at Barnsley. Norwich are a point above the relegation zone after defeat to Sheffield Wednesday. Coca-Cola League One. Leicester and Peterborough stay in the top two spots, but Posh have cut the gap to 2 points. And there's no change to the playoff places, which are occupied by Millwall, MK Dons, Leeds and Scunthorpe. No change to the bottom four. Defeats for all the teams today. Cheltenham, Hereford, Brighton and Hove Albion, Northampton, the bottom four as things stand. And let's take a look at Coca-Cola League Two. Brentford's lead at the top is down to 4 points after they conceded a late equaliser at Bradford. Exeter beat Dagenham and Redbridge to move into an automatic promotion place alongside Bury. Playoffs, Wickham, Rochdale, Gillingham, Shrewsbury. At the bottom, Chester remain in the relegation zone despite their first win since Boxing Day. Grimsby a point above them after their draw at Shrewsbury. The bottom side, Luton, play in the Johnston Paints Trophy final tomorrow at Wembley Stadium. The situation in the Blue Square Premier League. Top three all lost. Burton still well clear of Cambridge. Torquay move into third place above Histon, with Kidderminster occupying the final playoff spot. The bottom, Lewis already relegated. Northwich, who lost again today, still well adrift of safety. Woking and York City also in the relegation zone. And let's take a look at the Clydesdale Bank Scottish Premier League. Celtic lead the way by 6 points after their 4-0 win against Hamilton. Rangers can halve that gap when they visit Falkirk tomorrow. Hearts look well set for a European place after beating Kilmarnock at Tynecastle. At the foot of the table, St Mirren remain 3 points above bottom side Falkirk after their defeat at Inverness. In the Scottish League Division 1, St Johnstone remain 3 points clear at the top after drawing 1-1 with nearest rivals Partick Thistle. Clyde stay bottom after defeat to Livingston. Let's take a look at Division 2. And we can see that Ayr remain a point clear after beating Stirling Albion. Stranraer have been relegated after their defeat to second-placed Raith Rovers. And Scottish Division 3, Cowden and Beath still lead despite being held by bottom side Elgin today. Despite that draw, Elgin will finish the season bottom of the table. And in the Principality Building Society Welsh Premier, Rhyl won today, so they're 5 points clear at the top. No change at the bottom today because the bottom two didn't play. Rhyl and Llanelli are the top two as things stand. Plenty of post-match reaction to come after this summary of the top football stories of the day. Time is running out for the Tomb. No fairy tale start for Alan Shearer as Chelsea win with goals from Lampard and Malouda. Fuller and Beattie edged the Potters closer to safety to leave the Baggies on the brink of relegation. Bolton pile the pressure on Gareth Southgate and Middlesbrough with a 4-1 thrashing. Borough have now lost their last 9 away games. They've won 1 of 19. Bad news for the Black Cats. A debut goal for 19-year-old junior Stanislas helps the Hammers see off Sunderland. Both Hull and Portsmouth have work to do in their fight to avoid relegation after a goalless draw today. But the Gunners are firing at full strength again. Fabregas and Adebayor combine to give Arsenal victory against Manchester City. And it's a 10 o'clock start tonight for Match of the Day. As ever, all the goals, all the saves and all the major incidents from those games will be included in the programme. 10 o'clock start for Match of the Day. And the Fulham-Liverpool game, of course. Manchester United versus Aston Villa and the Everton women match centre stage tomorrow night at 10:25 in Match of the Day 2. Confirmation of the final scored entry, or final result, we should say, in the Grand National. 100-1 shot Monmouth won at entry this afternoon to become the biggest price winner of the race since 1967. The horse is trained by Venetia Williams and becomes the first woman since Jenny Pittman to train at the Grand National winner. Last year's winner, Comply or Die, was second of 14-1, with My Will third and State of Play in fourth. So, the reception Alan Shearer got from the St James's Park crowd this afternoon was quite incredible.
Yep.
And what about Newcastle's performance in their fight to try and avoid relegation? OK, they lost, but did you see any encouraging signs?
Great tempo, great attitude, and those are the platforms, in my opinion, he's got to build on. In terms of quality, needs to improve, but the dream's still alive. There are 4 bankable games, and those where he can actually... That's his escape route.
Steve Claridge, do you agree with Garth? Do you see any encouraging signs for Newcastle in their fight to avoid relegation?
Well, I point back to Man United at home and Arsenal home in recent times, and I didn't see a great deal of difference between the performance today and the performance against those two sides. They started very well. For an hour, they were very much in the game. But that just that little bit of lack of quality, that little bit of lack of belief, and one or two mistakes has cost them dear again. Undoubtedly, Colaccini won't sleep very well tonight after that.
Did you see defensive stability or any signs of defensive stability in the Newcastle side?
Well, no, because they give away a poor goal, and it's.
But across the whole game, Gary.
Across the whole game, yeah, the effort was there. They defended well, especially for an hour. I think they ran out of legs. They put so much effort into the first hour of the game. They ran out of steam, they're tired. And Chelsea, a professional outfit, they've got quality all over the pitch, and they were bound to start hurting Newcastle, and that's what it was. If they hadn't conceded that first goal, it might have been a different story, because they had something to hang on to. Once they give away such a poor goal like that, deflates the team, tired legs, you start feeling it even more, and you end up losing quite comfortably in the end.
And let's go to St James's Park, because we can hear from the Chelsea manager, Gus Hiddink.
Well, Gus, it's an important 3 points. You're not out of this title after all, are you?
Yeah, that's why we were saying before on forehand that we are still in the title race. And then you don't have to spoil the points here, which we didn't. I think we played a decent game, and we had a good chances to make one more. But it's difficult in this new circumstances here to play and win the game. But we did.
Was the plan early on just to keep things low-key, keep Newcastle quiet?
Of course, we knew that with the coming of Alan Shearer, that it would be supported by everyone. So we have to get off the noise of the game and try to play good triangles, good possession, but also tried to harm them. I think we had a rather good start.
Would you say it was a good professional performance from your players today?
I think they are used to the circumstances, and I think we did decent game. In the second half, we lost a little bit composure, 10 minutes, when we start kicking the long balls, and we were not that good. But for the rest, there were no big danger for us.
And yet, it was a long ball that led to your second goal.
That's true, and it was a very nice pass, and it was another pass of Balak on Kalu, which was a good long ball, but it was not kicking away. I don't like when they are kicking away. That's kind of panic, which I don't like.
Right, here's Newcastle's remaining games. If they're on 29, Garth, let's say they have to get to 40, or will 39 be enough, or where are they going to get points?
Well, I think there's points at Stoke City. I know they've won today, very important, but I think there's something there for them at Stoke. Portsmouth at home, Middlesbrough at home. What a game that is now, bearing in mind Middlesbrough are desperate and Fulham at home.
Do you see points for Newcastle in the games to come, Steve Claridge?
I do. I think they've got to start scoring goals. They've got to get a threat. They've got to get an edge to their game, and then they'll get belief that they can stay up.
How was Michael Owen today, Gary Pallister?
They didn't really pose that much of a threat. I think they had one maybe half chance in the first half. And yeah, he looks as though he's a bit short on match practice, but he's a goal scorer. He's, you know what I mean? Newcastle have got goal scorers in the team, in Martins and Michael Owen. You think, get them sharp, get them fast. But they've also got to give them the service. They didn't
absolutely
have the quality they did.
Goal scorers don't score unless they're supplied with the service. And he didn't get any of the service today.
But we're now in the situation as well with Middlesbrough, that second bottom, need points quickly.
Yes.
But it could be that Newcastle, if they get those points, relegate Sunderland.
Middlesbrough, Newcastle and Sunderland are in a dogfight. Suddenly, the whole spotlight of relegation goes to the northeast because they're all in it.
Steve, do you think Stoke and Bolton are now safe with victories today? What are they to get your first away with?
You don't want
to
try and surmise anything at this stage of the season because things can change very quickly. If they carry on in the current vein, they will stay up, undoubtedly. There are sides who are in worse form and sides who are certainly at the bottom are not picking up points. And you need to do that to get out of the situation they're in.
Can you give any hope to your former club, Middlesbrough? Is there any way do you think they can find points, find goals suddenly to stay up?
No, I can't see him finding goals, that's for sure. And today, defensively, right from the off, they were all over the place. Even looking at Garth there, he looks beaten on the sideline, which is a shame because I know he's put a lot of effort into it and all that, but he looked a beaten man today.
Could the sheer factor eventually still prove to be the decisive factor as far as Newcastle are concerned?
Without any shadow of doubt in my mind, that dream's not dead, but you're quite right in terms of Gareth Southgate. Today, for the first time on that sideline, he looked broken.
Well, it's time to close here on BBC Two. But via the red button, our football service will continue from now till 6 o'clock. All the league tables will cycle on the screen. We'll hear from several of the managers and players whose teams are desperately fighting to avoid relegation out of the Premier League. We hope to hear from Alan Shearer. Also between now and 6 o'clock, Gary, Steve and Garth will debate the issues of the day. This is where we say goodbye to BBC Two viewers.